Welcome, my friends. Today we will discuss the addition rules of probability and mutually exclusive events. When discussing two events A and B, addition rules are applied whenever we are interested in finding the probability of either A or B occurring. There are three different ways that the condition of A or B can be satisfied. First, only event A could occur. Second, only event B could occur. Third, both event A and event B could occur. Our everyday usage of the word or doesn't necessarily cover the third case, but when discussing probabilities, we include it. It's like me asking you to purchase either bagels or muffins from the bakery. If you came back with both muffins and bagels, the third condition, I might tell you that you haven't followed my instructions. I only wanted one or the other. But in terms of probability theory, we would say that you have satisfied my request of buying either bagels or muffins. So asking you to purchase bagels or muffins from the store could be met in any of these three ways. You could purchase bagels, but not muffins. You could purchase muffins, but not bagels. Or you could purchase both bagels and muffins. Now, in some cases, the third condition is actually impossible to fulfill. We call events that cannot happen at the same time mutually exclusive or disjoint events. If two events, A and B, are mutually exclusive, then the probability that A and B happen together is zero, therefore making the third condition impossible. For example, if you were to roll a six-sided die once, it's impossible for you to roll both a 1 and a 2. The events rolling a 1 and rolling a 2 are mutually exclusive, and therefore the probability of rolling both a 1 and a 2 in the same roll is 0. The addition rule for OR-type probabilities changes based on if the two events are mutually exclusive or not. If the two events A and B are mutually exclusive, meaning that they can't happen together, you can find the probability of A or B by simply adding the two individual probabilities together. If the two events A and B are not mutually exclusive, meaning that they can happen together, you can find the probability of A or B by adding the two individual probabilities together and then subtracting the joint probability of both A and B happening together. So why are we subtracting the probability of A and B in this formula? Well, it's because the probability of A and B actually gets double counted, once when we add the probability of A, and once when we add the probability of B. We only want to count it once, so we must subtract it off to get the correct probability. The second rule is often called the general addition rule because it works for any two events, regardless of if they are mutually exclusive or not. Notice that the second formula becomes the first formula if A and B are mutually exclusive events, since the A and B term equals zero for mutually exclusive events. You should default to using the general rule if you aren't sure if two events are mutually exclusive, but if you know that the two events are mutually exclusive, you can use the first formula. Let's look at some examples. Suppose that 60% of students in a statistics class are freshmen and 20% are sophomores. Let A equal students who are freshmen and B equal students who are sophomores. Do you think events A and B are mutually exclusive? The answer is yes. A student can't be both a freshman and a sophomore at the same time, so events A and B are mutually exclusive. What is the probability that a randomly selected student is either a freshman or a sophomore? Since these two events are mutually exclusive, we can use the addition rule for mutually exclusive events. Simply add up the two probabilities. The probability of A is 60%. And the probability of B is 20%. The probability of A or B is equal to 60% plus 20%, which is equal to 80%. There is an 80% chance that a randomly selected statistics student from this class will be either a freshman or a sophomore. What about this example? 30% of students in the same statistics class are business majors, 45% of the students in the class are male, and 10% of the students are both business majors and male. Let A equal the students who are business majors, and B equal students who are male. Are the events A and B mutually exclusive? The answer is no. a student can be both a business major and male at the same time, so these two events are not mutually exclusive. What is the probability of a randomly selected student being either a business major or male? Since these two events are not mutually exclusive, we need to use the general addition rule formula, which means that the probability of A or B is equal to the probability of A plus the probability of B minus the probability of A and B. The probability of A is 30%, the probability of B is 45%, and the probability of A and B is 10%. So the probability of A or B is equal to 30% plus 45% minus 10%, which is equal to 65%. There is a 65% chance that a randomly selected student from this class will be a business major or male. Alright, my friends, we have finished our discussion of the addition rule and mutually exclusive events. We will be exploring many more fun and exciting statistical topics that you won't want to miss, so make sure to check out our other videos.